Hal 16 natuurlijk, Global Challenges, Smart Solutions. Vooral de inzending van de Nederlanders. Maar we hebben ook internationale gasten, natuurlijk de Duitsers. Herzlich willkommen, Frau Itzer, Wirtschaftssenatorin in Berlin. We will do this interview in English because our target group is an international audience. So could you explain to me, please, what does the city of Berlin have to do with smart cities?
First of all, Berlin is a growing city, 30,000 more inhabitants within the last year, and we expect that 300,000 new inhabitants will come within the next 10 years. That means that we need new solutions for mobility, for industry 4.0, and of course people want to work and to live there. That means housing, attractive housing, but also sustainable building. That's what people are waiting for.
Yeah. But do you really need to be efficient when you have plenty of space?
Of course we have to be efficient, because at the end of the day we want to be successful, and that means that we have to create our city in a better way, in a more sustainable way, with less CO2 emissions than we had in the past. And of course we also want that people can afford to live within the center of the city, and that means efficiency is one of the most important issues.
Yeah. What other themes are you focusing on in Berlin? What are the main themes for Berlin?
One important issue is e-mobility. People want to be mobile. They like to have their cars, but car sharing is a top issue. Mm-hmm. And of course most of the Berliners want to have a car from time to time. Mm-hmm. Sharing is top, but if it is sharing, it should be an e-mobile car. Mm-hmm. And we also go for public solutions in the field of e-mobility, whether it's a police car, whether it's within the infrastructure of the city, the public companies, they all want to turn to e-mobility solutions to have less emissions.
Okay. So who are the partners in this chain within Berlin? Because it's of course not only a political issue, you need also partners to collaborate to get the most out of it.
That's true. It's an initiative called Window of E-Mobility. It's sponsored by the federal government of Germany, by the Berlin government, but more important is that we have research institutions involved, and of course companies. Mm-hmm. We'll have about 40 projects spending 100 million euro till 2015, in a quite short time frame. We want to bring e-mobility on the roads.
Yeah. And on an international level, who are the partners that you're looking at or already talked to?
Of course, we are looking at other smart cities in Europe, whether it's Amsterdam or Barcelona, London. And there is lots of exchange, because at the end of the day, it's not the question of competition. It's the question of doing it right by cooperation. And that's why we have lots of talks. We have an interministerial working group in Berlin. And we have lots of interchange with the partner cities of Berlin and with the cities, the smart cities already mentioned, to go for the best solutions of tomorrow.
Yeah, I mean, we have a theme here. It's called Global Challenges, Smart Solutions. What's your opinion on the Dutch, and how could they be integrated in this whole e-mobility concept that you're striving at in Berlin?
I think that we all in Europe have an interest in more energy efficiency. It's cost saving and it will save our nature. And sustainability is a driving force, especially when I think about the Dutch corporations we have. Sustainability, efficiency, these are the issues. When we talk about e-mobility, we are all aware that The first step is an urban solution. It's not a long-distance solution for the moment, mm-hmm. but we should start with urban solutions. And what I have in mind is that we have these projects in our European cities to demonstrate what is possible and to show that an upscaling with regard to mega cities in other parts of the world, especially in the Asian region, are attractive as well.
Yeah. So the whole fleet of Berlin are now e-cars, e-mobility within the Berlin government already?
No, we are far away from that, but we are on a good track. And in Berlin today, there are more e-cars on the road than in other any other German city, and that's important to be ahead. Mm-hmm. And of course, to stay ahead means to do more and more every day.
Yes. Okay, thank you so much, Frau Itzer. She's the Secretary of Economical Affairs for the State of Berlin. Thank you so much for your time.
And
thank you so much for visiting Hall 16, Global Challenges Smart Solutions. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Ja. Dank voor het kijken. Gebruik de hashtag Partnerland. De volgende interviews, het schema staat op de website. Soms zijn we iets later, dus excuus daarvoor. Maar ik hoop dat u blijft kijken, want we hebben nog veel interviews later vandaag. Bijvoorbeeld met John Blankendaal van de Brainport Industries uit Eindhoven. En ook nog de vice-burgemeester van Rotterdam, Alexandra van Huffelen, komt langs. Dus blijf vooral kijken en gebruik de hashtag Partnerland. Bedankt.